Hi guys, so we'll be continuing control systems in this lecture and we'll be starting with a new chapter, that is frequency response analysis. So first of all, in frequency response analysis there are certain topics such as frequency response, polar plot, Nyquist plot, Bode plot. So these sort of topics are there. Other than that, there are gain margin and phase margin. So in frequency response, what you have to remember, in this second order system matters a lot. So what is the transfer function of a second order system, closed loop transfer function? T of s is basically omega n square by s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square. And what is its equivalent open loop transfer function? Omega n square by s into s plus 2 zeta omega n. Okay? That is the open loop transfer function. Now when we convert it to frequency domain, we'll keep j omega in place of s. So omega n square minus omega square plus 2 j zeta n omega into omega plus omega n square. That is omega n square, omega n square minus omega square plus 2 j zeta omega n into omega. Other than that, what you have to remember is the first term is resonance frequency. This is basically represented by omega r. It is 1 minus 2 zeta square whole multiplied by omega n. Then next is resonant peak. It is given by MR. It is 1 upon 2 zeta under root 1 minus zeta square. Then we have bandwidth. Bandwidth expression is not so very important, but you can memorize the complete expression for bandwidth. It is a big expression. Okay. Other than that, what you have to remember is that is the time domain, sorry, the frequency domain approximation of dead time. Dead time is e to the power minus st. It will be now e to the power minus j omega t, or we can say 1 angle minus omega t. And you have to remember how to calculate the response of a system to sinusoidal input. That is, suppose if the transfer function is 1 upon s plus 1 and input is let us say r of t 2 sin t, then we will see that omega equal to 1 for the input. This will be h j omega 1 by 1 plus j omega. We will keep omega equal to 1, so 1 upon 1 plus j. So it is 1 by root 2 at an angle minus 45 degree. So the output will be 1 by root 2 will be multiplied by amplitude of sine. And this phase shift will appear inside sine, that is, it will come out to be root 2 sine of t minus 45. This thing also you have to understand in frequency response. So these are the basics of frequency response which are very much required. Other than that, you have to remember that resonance peak occurs only when zeta is less than 1 by root 2. Moving on to some problems. So in the first one, it is saying a second order control system has magnitude function. We have to find the peak magnitude. So let us see, first of all, let us compare it with the standard function omega n square by omega n square minus omega square plus 2 j zeta omega n into omega. So by comparison, what I can say is natural frequency is 10 radian per second. Then zeta is 101 root 2 divided by 2 into 10. That is how much? 100 by 20 is 5, 5.05 root 2. That is greater than 1, which I can say it is overdamped. Now, as I have told you, resonance peak only exists if zeta is less than 1 by root 2. In that case, resonance peak is how much? 1 by 2 zeta under root 1 minus zeta square. So remember, gate authorities can trick you into thinking that you can directly substitute zeta and find the resonance peak, But always remember, resonance peak will only exist if zeta is less than 1 by root 2. Otherwise, what happens? Maximum peak occurs at omega equal to 0. So if you keep omega equal to 0, the second term goes away. The third term also goes away. It is omega n square by omega n square, that is 1. Okay. So that is how you calculate the resonance peak if resonance does not occur or if zeta is greater than 1 by root 2. Moving to the next problem, it is saying the forward path transfer function of a unity feedback system is given by this. We need to find the frequency such that resonance peak occurs. Again, let us compare it to the standard transfer function. So by comparison, what I can say, omega n is basically 10 radian per second. What about zeta? 10 by 2 into 10, that is 0.5. So zeta is 0.5. So it is definitely less than 1 by root 2. So what is the resonance frequency? Omega n under root 1 minus 2 zeta square, that is 10 under root 2 into 0.5 square, 10 under root 1 minus 0.5, that is 10 by root 2, or we can say 7.07 radian per second. So answer will be C. Okay, so remember this condition, zeta less than 1 by root 2. Moving on to the next concept in frequency response analysis is polar plot. So polar plot is nothing but it is a plot of g of h j omega, and it is drawn on a polar plane where x axis is basically real part of gh and y axis is basically imaginary part of gh. Okay, that is where we draw the polar plot. In this, you have to remember angle at omega equal to 0. It is equal to minus 90 multiplied by P minus Z. Sorry, minus 90, not P minus Z. Minus 90 into type. Then angle at omega equal to infinity is minus 90 multiplied by P minus Z. So these are the two angles of the polar plot. So what we do is we first form GH J omega and then we calculate two things, its magnitude and its phase. Okay, and based on these two information at omega equal to 0 and omega equal to infinity, we draw the polar plot. Now in this case, there are some standard polar plots that you have to memorize. Like this is for type 0, order 2. Similarly, this is for type 0, order 1. Direction is like this. That means this is omega equal to 0, omega equal to infinity. So there are two rules. If add a pole at origin head and tail rotate clockwise by 90 degrees. What is meant by head and tail? So this omega equal to 0 is called as tail of polar plot, omega equal to infinity is called as head of polar plot. If we add a pole away from origin, only head rotates clockwise by 90 degrees. Okay, so if you see here, we have just increased the order from this to this, we haven't increased the type, which means we have added a pole away from origin. So if you see here, the angle of head was minus 90 and here it has become minus 180. So you have to understand about the angles of the axis. This is 0 degree, minus 90, minus 180, minus 270, minus 360. Like this, it will go on in a cycle. So that is the angle of the different axis. If you take clockwise, if you take anti-clockwise, you will take positive angles. So let us see first problem. It is saying the polar plot to the given system is. So the first step would be form GH J omega 1 plus 0.4 J omega 1 plus J omega 1 plus 8 J omega minus 1. So what about its magnitude? 1 plus 0.16 omega square by under root 1 plus 64 omega square. The magnitude of 1 minus j omega and j omega minus 1 will get cancelled out. What about the phase? So 1 plus 0.4 j omega tan inverse 0.4 omega. 1 plus j omega plus tan inverse omega. 1 plus 8 j omega minus tan inverse 8 omega j omega minus 1 180 minus tan inverse omega. So this phi will turn out to be tan inverse 0.4 omega plus 2 tan inverse omega minus tan inverse 8 omega minus 180 degree. Now when you take omega equal to 0 and infinity, at omega equal to 0 magnitude will be 1, because this omega terms will go to 0, 1 by 1 will be 1. At omega equal to 0, phase will be at 0, tan inverse will be 0, so minus 180. At infinity, magnitude, when you take infinity, you will take omega common, it will be like this, you will calculate. So it will come out to be 0.4 by 8, that is 0.05. So 0.05. What about phase at infinity? Plus 90 plus 180, minus 90 minus 180, that is 0. Okay, that means at infinity it must be at 0.05. That means I have only two options, either it is A or B. The only difference in A and B is the intersection with the real axis. Now whenever you wish to calculate the intersection of polar plot with any of the axis, whether it is real or imaginary, you do it by means of phase. So when it intersects negative real axis, phase must come out to be minus 180, because this is 0, minus 90, minus 180. So if phase is minus 180, so what I'll do, minus 180 will be equal to the phase that we have defined, tan inverse 0.4 omega plus 2 tan inverse omega minus tan inverse 8 omega and minus 180. So this gets cancelled out. So tan inverse 0.4 omega minus tan inverse 8 omega is 2 tan inverse omega. Now what we can do is tan inverse A plus tan inverse B. So tan inverse A minus tan inverse B is 0.4 omega minus 8 omega, 1 plus 3.2 omega square. Tan inverse omega plus tan inverse omega is tan inverse 2 omega by 1 minus omega square. Now tan inverse is a 1 to 1 function or a monotonic function, so we can equate the argument. So what I'll do is I'll first make some space. Okay, so it will be minus 7.6 omega by 1 plus 3.2 omega square. This must be 2 omega by 1 minus omega square. So the first solution is omega equal to 0. Then if you solve rest of the equation, you get omega equal to 2 root 2 radian per second. That is, there is another frequency at which phase will be minus 180. So we get the option as A. This frequency will correspond to omega equal to 2 root 2. If you see, there is no such intersection in this curve, so our answer would be A. Okay, that will be the correct answer. So if you are confused in one or two plots, it is better to determine the frequency at which it will cross a certain axis. If it crosses negative real axis, it is also called as phase crossover frequency. Next, the polar plot will intersect the real axis at, again the same thing. So what I'll do, I'll form GH j omega 1 by j omega to the power cube 5 plus j omega 20 plus j omega. Now if you take the angle of GH j omega, due to j omega cube it will be minus 270, then it will be minus tan inverse omega by 5 minus tan inverse omega by 20. If it crosses negative real axis or real axis, let me call the angle as minus 180. So 90 minus tan inverse 90 plus sorry tan inverse omega by 5, this is equal to minus tan inverse omega by 20. So taking tan both sides, tan of 90 plus theta is minus cot theta, tan of minus theta is minus tan theta. So from here we get omega is 10 radian per second. So at omega equal to 10 radian per second, the phase of the polar plot will come out to be minus 180 degree, which means it is intersecting the negative real axis. Okay. In the next question, it is saying if x is equal to real part of GJ omega and y is imaginary part, then Nyquist plot becomes asymptotic to the line. It is giving omega tending to 0 plus. Now, since you have to solve in real and imaginary part, it means we are now dealing in rectangular coordinates. We are not going to polar coordinates. Then what to do? First of all, again form GJ omega in such type of problems. 1 upon j omega 1 plus j omega 2 plus j omega. Now try to resolve it in real and imaginary part. So I'll take minus j upwards, my 1 minus j omega 2 minus j omega. In the denominator it will be omega, then 1 plus omega square, then 4 plus omega square. Now if you multiply minus j, then 2 minus minus plus 2 minus omega square, then minus 3j omega whole divided by omega. Now we can separate the real and imaginary term. Minus minus will become plus and j square will be minus 1. So minus 3 omega by omega 1 plus omega square 4 plus omega square, then the next term would be minus j 2 minus omega square by omega 1 plus omega square 4 plus omega square. So as omega tends to 0 positive, this gets cancelled, so it will be coming out to be minus 3 by 4 minus j infinity, because at 0 this omega will come out to be infinity. So that means the real part is minus 3 by 4 and imaginary part is infinite. So answer will be B. That is, it will touch a real line, that is x equal to minus 3 by 4. That will be the value, because the polar plot will be like this, type 1 order 3. So it will be asymptotic to this line, minus 3 by 4. Okay, that will be the answer. Now moving on to Nyquist plot. In Nyquist plot, what you need to understand is Nyquist plot is basically equal to polar plot plus inverse polar plot, that is mirror image of polar plot, plus number of infinite semicircle equal to type of system. Okay, so in this case, first of all, what we do is we draw the polar plot and then we draw its mirror image about the real axis, that is called as inverse polar plot, and then we sketch as many number of infinite semicircle as is the type of the system. Other than that, in Nyquist criteria, you have to remember the Nyquist criteria. So this criteria has two different meaning. N can be, first of all, number of encirclement of minus 1 comma 0 point. Okay, P is number of open loop poles in RHP, Z is number of closed loop poles in RHP. But if you take N is equal to encirclements of 0 comma 0 point, that is origin, then P is number of open loop poles in RHP and Z will be number of open loop zeros in RHP. So you can interpret this criteria in two ways, and the number of encirclement that will be taken positive for anticlockwise direction and negative for clockwise direction. So number of encirclement equal to P minus Z. P can be open loop poles in RHP, Z can be closed loop poles in RHP or open loop zeros in RHP. You just have to check if you are encircling origin or the minus 1 plus J0 point. In the next, it is saying the Nyquist plot of a unity feedback system has no open loop poles in RHP. According to Nyquist criteria, this means P equal to 0 because P is the number of open loop poles in RHP. The closed loop system is, now if you see critical point minus 1, it is being encircled by the polar plot or Nyquist plot once in clockwise direction. Due to clockwise, we will use a negative sign. Now N is since equal to P minus Z, Z equal to P minus N. There is no open loop poles in RHP, N is minus 1, so it will be 1. So there is 1 closed loop pole in RHP because we are checking encirclement of minus 1 point. That means the system is unstable because there is one pole that lies in the right half plane. It is saying Nyquist plot of a certain stable system is given. We have to find the acceleration error coefficient. Now if you see, there are two infinite semicircle. One is like this, one semicircle, and the second one is like this, that is second semicircle. So number of infinite semicircle equal to 2, which must also be equal to type. That is, this polar plot represents a type 2 system. If it is a type 2 system, then what we have to do is we can understand that K must be finite, and in type 2 system Kp and Kv are both 0. So if K is finite, the only finite option out of the given ones is T. We can never calculate the exact value in this case because we don't have any information about Nyquist plot. Where does it intersect the negative real axis and where does it intersect the imaginary axis? So we have to go with the next possible option, that is finite. Okay, so answer will be 10. In the next one, it is saying the Nyquist plot of a system is shown. The open loop transfer function is given also. We have to find number of closed loop poles in RHP. Now if you observe this transfer function, it has no poles in RHP. There is one pole at 0, one at minus 1, one at minus 0.5, but none of them are in RHP. But if we see here, this is 10.64, so minus 1 will lie inside. If minus 1 is lying inside, it is being encircled once in clockwise direction and other time by infinite circle again in clockwise direction. So it is encircled twice in clockwise direction, which means N will come out to be minus 2. p will come out to be 0, z equal to p minus n will be 2. So there are two closed loop poles in RHP. Okay, so answer will be 2. In the next problem, it is giving me a open loop transfer function of a control system. We need to find the Nyquist plot. Before drawing Nyquist plot, what I'll do is I'll draw polar plot. GH j omega is minus 1 by 2 j omega 1 minus 20 j omega. So what about magnitude? 1 by omega under root 1 plus 400 omega square. What about phase? Minus 90 plus 10 inverse 20 omega. So at omega equal to 0, m is infinite and phase is 0. When omega equal to infinite, magnitude is 0 and phase is also minus 90 plus 90, it will be 0. So phase will actually, we can't write directly like this. Let me change it a bit. Actually, this lies in fourth quadrant. Real part is positive, imaginary part is negative. So what I'll do is, first of all, when it will go above, it will be not minus j, plus j. Then it will be minus 10 inverse 20 omega. When it go into the numerator, it will be plus 10 inverse 20 omega. So at omega equal to 0, phase will be 90. At omega equal to infinity, phase will be 180. Okay. So that will be the phase of the transfer function. So what I have done here is I have just made use of the negative sign. Okay, negative sign is given on the top, so that we have to take care. So 90 to 180, if you see, as you increase omega, this phase will go on increasing and it will go from 90 to 180. That means it will be drawn in second quadrant. Okay. So it will be like this. This is omega equal to 0, where magnitude is infinite and angle is 90. Omega equal to infinite, where angle magnitude is 0, angle is 180. Now we will take mirror image of this. It will be like this. And then we will draw a clockwise semicircle like this. Why clockwise semicircle? Because it has type 1. So there must be one infinite semicircle. So answer will be B. Okay, that way we can draw the polar plot. Moving on to last problem, it is saying the Nyquist plot of a stable transfer function is shown in the figure. We are interested in stability of the closed loop system. So now if you see this minus 1 point, it is not encircled. It does not lie inside the Nyquist plot. So we have to check origin. Origin is being encircled by the Nyquist plot once in clockwise direction. Now it is saying the open loop system is stable, that is there are no open loop poles in RHP. So P equal to 0 means no open loop poles in RHP. That means when minus 1 is equal to 0 minus z, so z will be 1. Now this z is not the closed loop pole, it is the open loop 0. So there will be one open loop 0 in the right half plane. So answer will be B. Okay, whenever you are not checking the encirclement of minus 1 point, you have to check encirclement of origin. Such kind of problems can also be asked. So these are the type of problems that have been asked from in gate examination from different topics belonging to Nyquist plot, polar plot and frequency response. In the next lecture, what we'll do is we'll see what kind of problems can be phrased in your gain and phase margin and the Bode plot. So next time our sole focus will be Bode plot and gain margin, phase margin. Till then, take care.